Hi fellow dog fanciers, welcome back to a new video. This is the second time I'm filming this because the first time, halfway throughout the video, I realized that I have forgotten the fish tank lights on and they make a ton of noise, they ruin my sound, so here we go again. I decided to do this video in the middle of summer because it's not too late yet, and so why not? Today I will tell you about some of the things you can do to help your dog be cooler in the dreadful hot summer days. And at the end of the video I will tell you about the honestly best tools I have ever used for brushing whippets. If you haven't subscribed yet, I will highly appreciate if you do so. I make some videos on hot canine, whippet and other pet topics, and I'm sure you don't want to miss those. Before we start, tell me in the comment section what are your tips and tricks for keeping your dogs cool in summer. Let's get into the video. While we are enjoying summer and the lovely sunny days, it's not necessarily as enjoyable for our four-legged pets. Unlike us, they can't take a layer of clothes, respectively fur off, and they can't go to the pool or the beach whenever they please to cool down. So dogs can be in a real danger of overheating, which can also be life-threatening. I have witnessed a dog die due to overheating, and even though it wasn't my dog, it was heartbreaking regardless. So we as the responsible human figure have to attend to our dog's needs and make sure that the hot days are as comfortable for them as possible. First things first, when you take your dog for a walk, do that in the early morning or in the late afternoon when the temperatures are cooler and the sun is not so strong. Going for a walk, let alone exercising or doing sports with your dog in the middle of the day or when the temperatures are at their highest and the sun is at its hottest, is highly irresponsible, completely unnecessary and very dangerous to your dog. And not only are the temperatures high, but pavements can get so hot that your dog can literally burn their feet. And if today you don't have the possibility to take your dog for a walk in the cooler times of the day, just skip the walk. It's a true saying that no dog has died from skipping one walk, but many have died because of one walk in the heat. The next one should be pretty obvious, but still apparently not to some people, so let's cover it anyways. Give your dog access to fresh water throughout the day, which means very frequent water bowl refills. When your dogs are hot, they will drink a lot of water, just as almost any other living being. And if you have a dog that drools a lot, that means that the water will get dirty every time they dip their nose in the bowl. But even if you don't have such a dog, you still should change their water very frequently because they deserve fresh, cool water throughout the day. If necessary, you can even place more than one bowl around your house. We have one in each bathroom and two or three outside in the shade, so the whippets have access to fresh, cool water wherever they are. Obviously, keep your dogs in the house in the hottest times of the day, or if you have a dog that spends most of the time outside for whatever reason, make sure that they have access to a cool, comfortable spot at all times. And here is a fun fact about whippets. They love to lie in the sun. Typically, they're smart enough not to do that in the middle of the day, and you would usually witness them sunbathing in the early mornings or in the late afternoons, and they would do that until they're almost overheated. If you're a new whippet owner and you witness this, don't worry, your dog is not broken. They just love to do that sometimes. And if you have a fireplace in winter, you will see them do the same. They will lie in front of the fire until they're almost overheated. Let's now talk about some of the tools you can use to keep your dog cooler, starting with cooling towels for dogs. You can cover your dog with one of those, or you can cover their favorite sleeping spot so they can be cool when they lie on the towel. These are honestly amazing, and even I like to use them myself sometimes. We bring them at shows because they don't make the coat wet, and I keep them on just before we're about to enter the show ring if it's too hot or too sunny. You can also use cooling mats for dogs. These are fantastic as well. They have a gel in them which keeps the surface of the mat very, very cold. And they're fantastic for your dog to lie on them. Just keep in mind that if you have a chore, you shouldn't really leave them unsupervised, with one of those being there, done that. If you don't have access to any of those, don't worry, there are some other alternatives. You can simply use a regular towel, make it wet, put it in the fridge or freezer for a few hours, and then when it's cold enough, take it out and use it to cover your dog with it or place it under your dog. And you can do that with a few towels so that you can rotate them whenever the one you're currently using is not cold or wet enough. You can give your dogs ice cubes. The Whippets here are huge fans of those. We have a bowl full of ice cubes in the living room, and you will witness them, all of them actually, pass by the bowl, and some will just take a cube out and bring it somewhere to chew it up. Others will just lick through the cubes, but all of them definitely enjoy them. Similar to ice cubes, but tastier, would be frozen yogurt treats. I have never made those, but probably I should. Those are simply yogurt mixed with blueberries or another treat. And once you have the mixture, you fill in ice cube trays, you put them in the freezer, and when they're ready, you feed. You should be able to do that with plain yogurt as well, because most dogs are crazy about it. You can place a shallow pool or a wide bucket of water in your garden or your balcony, and soon enough your dog will figure out that dipping their feet in the water will help them feel cooler. We have neither of those because we have this instead, and the Whippets will walk through it, but unfortunately I haven't managed to catch it in a video just yet. If you have a long-coated dog, make sure you brush them frequently to get rid of any dead coat or mats, especially now when most dogs are shedding like crazy. Obviously, never leave your dog or any other pet for that matter in a hot car. I believe this is very obvious. There is so much information on the topic out there, and it should be a matter of logic. If you think that leaving your animal in a hot car is fine, I am quite certain that you shouldn't be allowed to own even a goldfish. If you have a double-coated dog, please don't shave them unless it's for medical reasons, because you will achieve the exact opposite of what you're thinking you will. Double-coated dogs, as the name suggests, have two layers of coat which help them be warmer in winter and help them cool down in summer. So if you shave them, you will ruin the coat structure and obviously its purpose, and you will expose your dog's skin to the heat and the sun. Not to mention that the coat might never have the same beautiful, healthy look when it starts growing back. Now, as promised, let me tell you about the newest discovery I've made, which might be helpful to Whippet owners and other short-haired dog owners. If you've watched my previous short video, you have probably seen how well this thing does its job for shedding Whippets, and you're probably wondering what type of brush is that. Plot twist, it's not even a brush. This little ring toy here is probably the best tool I've used for brushing a short-haired dog ever. I can't really recommend the brand, but I see them in every single pet store I go to, which makes me think that they should be available worldwide. So that's a flexible rubber ring with spikes, and the material, to be exact, according to the labels, is thermoplastic. We have several from different brands, and they all perform the same and do wonders, and they're quite cheap too. So if you come across something similar in your nearby pet stores, Buy it, use it, you will not have a single regret. And that was it for today's video. I hope you did enjoy. I wish you a fantastic weekend and a lovely week afterwards. And I will see you next time with a new video. Bye-bye.